Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. Amy here. Today's gonna be another read with me. I apologize for not having a normal video to go up on this lovely Wine Wednesday. Life happens. Been having a lot going on. No worries, everything's fine. Just had like some routine doctor visits that I needed to get past. But we're past, all is good. Time to get back to our regular scheduled programming. So today we're just gonna chill a little bit, just relax, because I've been pretty stressed. So I just wanna take some time for myself a little while. And we're gonna read a little bit of Brigs Ferry Bay by Kay Webster and Misty Walker. I have really been enjoying this book. The glare is there. I might have to close those blinds. But anyway, this is actually the complete series of the Brigs Ferry Bay series. I'm on book one, which is called Sheriff's Secret. So we have Sheriff Jackson Bell. Of course, Brigs Ferry Bay is a very small town, just very used to its small town life, its small town stores, those kind of things. Jackson is a closeted gay because of his homophobic father, probably as well as mother. I'm on chapter 22 and I hate his parents. and then we also have Dante Kincaid. Dante is from the big city of New York. He and his sister and his brother moved to Brigs Ferry Bay. And they bought this property and they are renovating this house, I guess, to be a B&B, a bed and breakfast. And Dante is running into all kinds of problems with trying to get his B&B started up. And I personally at this point think it's because of the fact that he is gay and the community is being homophobic assholes. Which is why Jackson had to stay in the closet. Dante is very outwardly gay. His younger brother is also outwardly gay and is having trouble at his school. Jackson's brother is also in school, same grade as Dante's younger brother. Dante and his siblings lost their parents, and so basically Dante and his sister, I guess, are raising their younger brother. Jackson is just trying to live his life as best he can. And he has his younger brother that apparently has caused trouble before in the household, but his parents gave him like three strikes and you're out kind of thing. So Jackson takes him in. Anyway, long story short, our couple is Jackson and Dante. At first, when they first meet, Jackson does not like Dante. He thinks Dante is coming into his little town to destroy his little town and destroy him. Jackson is also still getting over his high school sweetheart, which is Kian or Kian. Not really sure how to pronounce his name, but he came out at graduation. Wanted Jackson to come out with him. That didn't work out for Jackson, so they split their separate ways. Kian is still living in Brigs Ferry Bay and has his own sort of like wine bar / gay nightclub. So there's a little bit of backstory with that. So Jackson's been kind of hung up on Kian, and then Dante comes into the picture. Dante, of course, is super hot and super sexy, very handsome man. Jackson can't seem to stop thinking about him, even though he claims he doesn't like him. But the more he gets to know Dante, the more that he does like him. So I feel like their startup was a definitely very insta lusty, and it's kind of turning into an insta love. But I feel like it was done in a good way. It's only been a week. We're on chapter 22. A lot has happened, I feel, in that week. I'm gonna have to close those blinds. And I'm talking too much. Let's get to reading. let me know in the comments down below what you are reading. But yeah, I'm anxious to see what happens with Jackson and Dante, if their relationship is gonna be able to go anywhere. Will Jackson be able to come out and stand up to his parents? Dante has agreed to play around with him while he's in the closet, or in Dante's words, I'll play with you in their closet if you want to. I really like Dante. And I like Jackson as well. Jackson's very sweet. So yeah, I'm anxious to see how it's gonna pan out. I'm sure there's gonna be some drama. Haven't really gotten too much of the drama, although there is some vandalism, some homophobic vandalism that is happening to Dante and his brother, which is not cool. So that's kind of where I'm at. So let's get to reading. I'm gonna close these blinds first. y'all, I think that's gonna be it. I don't know how long that was, but I got to chapter 25. But I'm getting hungry, so I think I'm gonna go make me some dinner and hopefully get this video edited and posted for y'all. Not much editing, it's just me sitting in a chair reading. So hope y'all enjoyed it. Of course, let me know in the comments what y'all read or what y'all did while y'all sat here and watched me read. The homophobic vandalism continues. Jackson and Dante just have such good chemistry together. They're smoking hot together. Now, I will say this book is a bit on the smutty side. There's lots of sexy times in here, but it's very good sexy times. Highly recommend if you have not read this series or even this first book. It's really, really good. Anyway, I'm enjoying it, but of course I will keep you posted on it. It's only the first one in that series and the huge book that I have, but we're gonna keep going because I'm really enjoying the series. All right, y'all, I'm rambling. Hope you're having a wonderful Wine Wednesday, and I will see y'all in my next video. Bye, y'all.